in the house of the Lord to worship and just declare our love for Him, such a joy. If you are a believer, you are a Christian, this is the desire of your hearts, to always worship the Lord. Not just on Sunday, but every day of your life. Amen, Duba? Amen. How many of us believe that God's Word is alive and active and sharper than a two-edged sword? That's what the Bible says, right? That's what the Bible says. And so whenever God's Word is taught or preached, we should expect that God's Word will penetrate to our hearts. It will penetrate to our hearts because it's active. It's sharper than a two-edged sword. So I am hopeful and expectant that God's Word will come into our hearts to continue to live for the glory of God. Amen. Before I go to the Word, I want us to do a little bit of exercise. I want us to, first of all, if you have your smartphone, if I may request to turn it to silent mode, you know, because we will be talking about silence. If you can put it on silent mode. And then I will request everyone to keep silent for a while. That means wala mo nang usapan, no talking, no whispering. If you're going to go to washroom or whatever, don't make any noise. You want a complete silence, all right? I just want us to feel what silence is all about. Because hey, we haven't really used to silence. Our lives are always in a hurry. Lagi tayo nagmamadali, lagi maingay ang ating paligid. It's so noisy around us, even in our hearts and minds. It's noisy out there or in there. So I'll give a time. Let's take a moment of silence. You may want to close your eyes if you want to. And then I'll give you a cue when we're done with the silence moment. Okay? Are you okay? Let's begin. Let's just keep silent. Okay, that's 2 minute silence. Wake up na. Ito nakatulog na ata. It feels good. It feels good to have those kind of moments when we are silent and there's silence. Some of you maybe may felt uncomfortable with that. Kasi we get used to noise and noise and noise, right? Kaya pagka silent na parang, what's this? You know, we're uncomfortable with silence. And we get used to always in a hurry, always busy, always thinking a lot of things, worried a lot of things, right? Yun lang, ano ba na iniisip niya? Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Silence. Silence. Some people doesn't like silence. For them, silence is like waste of time. That 2 minute silence, Pastor, binigyan mo kami ng 2 minute silence, sayang yung oras ko. You know, my time is wasted. I have come here to listen to God's word. And what's that 2 minute silence about? But do you know that God wants us to take times of silence? Gusto ng Diyos na tayo, we take time of silence. It's Psalm 46:10. Sabi doon, be still. Be still. That means you're just silent. You're not doing anything. You're not busy. You're not active. Just be still. And know that I'm God. In Isaiah 32:17, the effect of righteousness will be peace. The result of righteousness, quietness. Ganun pala ang mga binabago ng Diyos, nagiging quiet. Hallelujah. And trust forever. Habakkuk 2:20, the Lord is in His holy temple. Let all the earth be silent before Him. The Lord is in His holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent. I've been in a gathering, in a religious gathering. Pagpasok mo pa lang, when you enter the room, it's quiet. It's so, no one is talking, no one is moving. It's like, quiet. My prayers sometimes, you know, when we come to the house of God, we have come to worship the Lord. You didn't come for me or for your friends. Of course, you know, we want to gather together, but above all, we are here to meet with our God. And so I pray that when we come here, immediately you will sense the presence of God, and you'll just take your seat and just be silent, preparing your heart in worshiping the Lord. Amen? Amen po ba? Minsan po kasi, you know, when we come together, actually, nagsisimula na ang service. May mga nag-uusap pa din. Parang wala si Lord dito. You know, if the Lord is here, which we believe He is, then when we come, we give Him reverence. We give Him the reverence in our hearts. Kung si President Trump nga ang nandito, I'm sure you will agree. Right? When the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords is here, God said that all the earth be silent. And do you know also that God sometimes chooses to be silent? Ang Diyos, tumatahimik din. You know, from the last book of the Old Testament, which is Malachi, to the New Testament, the first book of the New Testament, where Jesus came, that was 400 silent years. 400 silent years. God has no word. God has no revelation. God has not done any signs and wonders. Wala po. It was totally silent. God. So let me tell you today, kapatid, that great things can happen in silence. And God can use silence to make a difference in your life and my life. If you have your Bibles with you, would you turn to 1 Kings 19:11 to 12? This is in the Old Testament. 1 Kings 19:11 to 12. This is the journey of Elijah. Okay, there you go. Beside Jonathan, let's read it together. And he said, go out and stand on the mount before the Lord, and behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and strong wind tore the mountains and broke in pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, the sound of a low whisper. Now we will take a look at this. But to understand this passage, we have to know what happened to Elijah. Because this is pretty much Elijah's story. See, the great prophet Elijah. Elijah is so accustomed, he's so familiar. He experienced a lot of God's supernatural miracles. Sino po sa atin naka-witness na ng mga mirakulo ng Diyos? Amen? Have you seen miracles of God in your life? Elijah had seen supernatural. It's not natural. It's the hand of God, a powerful hand of God, firsthand, which means hindi po ito praise report na binigay sa kanya. He saw it firsthand, the powerful word of God. Let's begin in chapter 18. Si Elijah po, when he went to a widow in Sarepat, during that time there is the gutom, there is drought, there is lack of supply of food, and therefore, no, when Elijah approached the widow, sabi ni Elijah sa kanya, ma'am, can you give me a little bit of bread? I'm hungry. Now, the widow said to Elijah, as the Lord your God lives, sabi ni woman, I have nothing baked, only a handful of flour. Handful na lang na flour, may flour. What is flour?
Harina.
And a little oil in a jar. Yun na lang. And now I'm gathering a couple of sticks, that I may go and prepare it for myself and my son, that we may eat it and die. Banana, that's the last. Last na lang yun, they may bake and then they will die because no more, there's no more food. Now Elijah said to him, oh, do not fear, but first make me a little cake, bring it to me, and afterward make something for yourself and your son. For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, the jar of flour shall not be spent, hindi mauubos ang iyong harina, right? The jug of oil shall not be empty, alright? And until the day the Lord sends rain upon the earth. And so that happens, the jar of flour was not, hindi nauubos, bake sila ng bake. Hindi na ubos yung harina, hindi na ubos yung oil. Hallelujah, it's a miracle! It's God's work! It's supernatural work of God! And then after that miracle, the son of the widow got sick, nagkasakit, and eventually died. Ito sabi ng widow, what have you done? Elijah, what have you against me, O man of God? You have come to me to bring my sin to remembrance, to cause the death of my son. Ano ba ito? And then Elijah took the son and prayed to God. And said, O Lord my God, let this child's life come to him again. Dead. Naranasan niyo na bang ipag-pray ang patay? Elijah prayed. And the Lord listened to the voice of Elijah, and the life of the child came into him again, and he revived. Supernatural work of God firsthand. He prayed, God listened. Next thing, Elijah said to the Israel, All the people, come together, let's come together. Let's have, let's see who is the true God of Israel. You may know the story. There are false prophets, Nibal, the false gods, was being worshipped at that time. And of course, this Elijah, the true prophet, worshipping the Lord God. Sabi ni Elijah, let's have a contest. Let's have a showdown. All right, we will prepare a sacrifice. Whoever God answers by fire, he is the true God. All right, so yun ang deal. Yeah, sabi ng Israel, mga Israelites, yeah, let's see who is the true God. And so the false prophets began. They prepared the sacrifice and they started to pray, Baal, oh Baal, oh Baal, please, please answer us. And there was no answer, no fire. They cried again, Baal, Baal, please show to these people that you are our true God. Baal, answer us. Wala. Alas 12 na, tanghali na. Wala pa rin sabi ni Elijah sa kanila, sige pa! Sige pa! Iyak pa kayo ng iyak kasi baka natutulog ang Diyos nyo. Your God may be sleeping or maybe he's in a journey. Call him more, call him more. So those false prophets call, Baal, 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 Baal. They are cutting their bodies and blood is gushing out of their bodies. Baal, Baal, hear us. There's no answer, no fire. Then Elijah. Elijah's turn. Sabi ni Elijah, buhusan niya ng tubig. Pour out water upon the sacrifice. Binuhusan ng tubig. Do it one more time. Tubig. Do it another time. Talagang bamba na. Tubig. Talagang basang-basang-basa yung sacrifice. Just to make sure na walang magsasabi it's because nagkaroon lang ng spark yan. Kaya nagka-fire. Tubig. Talagang tubig na. It's all water. Elijah prayed. Sabi ni Elijah, oh Lord, simple lang eh. It's just one sentence prayer. Oh Lord, answer me that these people may know that you are, oh Lord, our God, and that you have turned their hearts back. One sentence prayer. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering and the wood and the stones and the dust and licked up the water that was in the trench. And when the people saw it, they fell on their face and said, the Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God. Oh, first time experience, seeing the power of God. Elijah prayed and God answered with a spectacular and powerful way of sending fire from heaven. Some of them, no? Do you want to experience those? Right? You pray for something, you know, something impossible, something that you think will not happen, but God answered. Amen. God answered. The testimony of Sister Ella, testimony of Sister Odette, your testimony. You have those times when you prayed about something that you think, ngayari kaya, ngayari kaya, will this happen? But you have faith and the Lord delivered you. You have witnessed that. You have seen God move in your life. Amen po ba? You have seen the move of God. And then, in chapter 18, lastly, it was already 3.5 years, Elijah prayed that it will not rain in Israel. And then 3.5 years, there was no rain. So miracle! 3.5 years, walang ulan, there's no rain because Elijah prayed, Lord, don't send rain. Now after 3.5 years, this time, Elijah prayed, Lord, now is the time, send us rain. And the Lord answered Elijah. Miracles of miracles. Shower of rain. Okay. And so Elijah, I hope you're getting the point here. Elijah is a man of faith. Elijah is a courageous, brave servant of God. Palaban to si Elijah. Palaban. You know, he's a strong person, a strong man, a servant of God, seeing the miracles of God. For him, nothing is impossible. For God, nothing is impossible. He believed that. He has faith on that. Now, here's the thing. Come to chapter 19. Chapter 19. Si King Ahab, may asawa siya. The name is Jezebel. So, Jezebel, this is a kind of a woman, a unique woman, matapang, about Mercy Jezebel. So I mean, Jezebel learned about what Elijah had done with the false prophets. Because when Elijah won victoriously on the Mount Carmel showdown, he killed all the false prophets. Now, Jezebel said to him, "So may the gods do to me and more also, if I do not make your life as the life of one of them by this time tomorrow." So this was like a death threat to Elijah. Alright? Death threat. Sabi ni Jezebel, bukas, the same time, Elijah, you're dead. You're dead. Now, imagine with me, think with me. Elijah is a man of faith. Right? He experienced God, the supernatural work of God. Ano dapat response ni Elijah rito? Nagbigay ng threat ang si Jezebel, napapatayin siya. What do you think should be the response of Elijah? What do you think? Kung man of courage ka, man of faith ka, you've seen firsthand the miracles of God, wala dapat yun. Who are you, Jezebel? Right? My God is the king of this universe. Don't you know that, Jezebel? You cannot harm me. You cannot kill me. I am a servant of the living God. Dapat ganun, di mo ba? But look what happened. After he heard, narinig na yung death threat. Verse 3, he was afraid. Natakot. He was afraid. And he arose and ran for his life. Elijah? Afraid? Elijah? Run? Maybe this is different Elijah. But no, it's the same Elijah. It's the same Elijah who won the victory, who has performed miracles by the power of God, and now he is afraid of a death threat of a woman and ran away. And so he ran until he was so tired. And in verse 4 it says, oh, he prayed to God. God, it's enough. It's enough, God. Now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am no better than my fathers. Ano nangyari kay Elijah? What happened to Elijah? Bakit siya sabi, take my life? Kanina, it's so powerful, it's so victorious, now take my life. What happened to Elijah? Ano nangyari? He was so disappointed. At this time, he was so disappointed, he was so afraid, that now he ran for his life. Question, where is God? Where is God who sent the fire? Where is God who raised the dead? Where is God? When the death threat was given to Elijah, where is God? Exactly the question of Elijah. He didn't see God. There's no word from God. There was no protection from God. Kaya nga siya tumakbo eh. He didn't sense the presence. There was no spectacular thing that happened. There was no like a sign that God would protect him. Nothing. God is silent. Taimik ang Diyos. And even here, when Elijah said, take my life, God was silent. Hindi sinagot siya, hindi siya tinagot ng Lord. The Lord didn't respond to Elijah. The only thing that Elijah did, alam niyo kung ginawa ng Panginoon, he allowed Elijah to sleep. Isn't God good? Sleep ko muna, anak. Rest. Sometimes that's what we need, right? When we are disappointed, when you are frustrated, kailangan lang natin itulog eh. Kasi masyado tayong pagod. Masyado tayong busy. Masyado tayo, we think a lot of things. You know, rest for a while. Have a break. I hope our brothers and sisters who are not with us I'm praying that they will have a time of rest, a time where they can just commune with the Lord in places where they are right now. We need that. We need physical rest. We need to rest our minds, right? We need to rest our physical body. But obviously, even after Elijah rested, may problema pa rin si Elijah. Because when he was in the Mount of God, in Horeb, the Mount of God, now the word came to Elijah. God's word came. Ang tanong ng Diyos, God asked Elijah, what are you doing here? It's in verse 9 to 11. Sabi, what are you doing here, Elijah? And Elijah said, I have been very jealous for the Lord, the God of hosts, but the people of Israel have forsaken your covenant, thrown down your altars, killed your prophets with a sword, and I only am left, ako na lang natira, and they seek my life to take it away. Kung rephrase natin konti, sabi ni Elijah kay Lord, Lord, mahal-mahal kita. I've given you my life. I've given my life to you. I dedicated my life to you. But I'm seeing a problem here, God. Your people, Israel, have forsaken your covenant. They're not turning back to you. They have thrown down their altar. Hindi sila nag-worship sa inyo, Lord. And they killed all your prophets. Ako na lang natin na, Lord. Ako na lang. That's verse 9 and 10. The one we read earlier is verse 11 to 12. Now, I want you to observe this. Verse 9 and 10, verse 11 and 12, and then verse 13 to 14. Verse 9 to 11 and verse 13 to 14, in between is 11 to 12, right? 9 and 10, 13 to 14 are almost exactly the same. God asked Elijah, what are you doing here, Elijah? He asked the same question, what are you doing here, Elijah? Elijah answered, I've been zealous for God, for the God, the Lord, the God of hosts. Your people have forsaken your covenant, thrown down the same, and they killed your prophets, and I'm left, and they seek my life. The same. But the difference is this, ang kaibahan po ganito. Doon sa second time that God asked and Elijah answered, God responded and God told Elijah what to do. So itong gawin mo, this is what you do. In verse 13 to 14. Now, kung pag nag-aaral po kayo ng word, you have to ask a question. It's the same question, the same answer. Same question, same answer. Bakit at this time, inutusan na ni God si Elijah to do something? Why not here? Why not here? It's the same. Bakit hindi lang the first time na nagtanong si Lord, God, where are you, Elijah? And Elijah said, blah, 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 that did this. Why not right there, God said, okay, you go back, you know, I'll give you instruction. Why? Now we come to verse 11 and 12. There is significant thing that happened in verse 11 and 12 that changed the heart of Elijah. And I believe if we will embrace this, it will change us as well. Mababago po ang ating pananaw, mababago ang ating buhay when we embrace this. What happened in verse 11 and 12? Ano po ba nangyari? Let's go back to 11 and 12. There you go. Let's go back there. Let's read it one more time. He said, go out, stand on the mount before the Lord. Behold, the Lord passed by, great and strong wind tore the mountains, broke in pieces the rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. Sabi ni Lord, God, ki Elijah, come, go out and stand on the mountain before the Lord. God tells Elijah, you will meet with me, I will meet with you. Alright? We will meet together. Go and stand on that mountain before the Lord. And so Elijah was there. He was there on the mountain and waiting for God. is waiting for God. And God passed by, he says. God passed by. What happened there? There's a great and strong wind tore the mountains and broke in pieces the rocks before the Lord. Now, remember I told you, Elijah is so accustomed with the power of God. He's so accustomed with miracles and all the spectacular things that God is doing. And so when Elijah saw this great, I mean, he felt the great wind that really shook the mountain and breaks the rocks in pieces, sabi ni Elijah, God is here. Now they don't know. Okay, Lord, okay. Okay, I want to see you, Lord God. I want to meet with you, Lord. Ano po sabi sa text? Ano po sinabi sa Bible? Nandun ba ang Lord? Wala si Lord. The Lord was not in the wind. Tataka si Elijah. This must be God, because I know when God is present, He works wonders, signs and wonders, spectacular things happen when God is there. But the Lord was not. And then earthquake again, another thing, napaka spectacular, thing, powerful thing. And God was, and Elijah was like, okay, maybe this time God is here. The Lord was not in the earthquake. Wala rin ang Lord. Hindi nagpakita ang Lord. Now the third, there was this, after the earthquake is fire. Now you remember the miracle of God sending fire? So at this time, maybe probably Elijah was saying, oh, I know this. Fire from heaven, I know this. It is coming from God. I'm sure I'm going to meet God now. But the Lord was not in the fire. Nakikita niyo ba where it is going? The Lord was not in the fire. Why would God do this to Elijah? Why would God do this? Why would God? What's the point of this? What is God teaching Elijah? What is God teaching us with this passage? You see, Elijah has a problem. And I think most of us can relate to that problem. We have that problem too. Alam niyo po problema ni Elijah. Here's the problem with Elijah. Elijah believed that when there's something spectacular happen, God is there. See? The miracle of the flour and the oil, the miracle of the sun, nabuhay, came alive, the miracle of the fire, the miracle of the rain, God was there. And that's what he believes. Elijah believed that when these things are happening, God is there. When there are signs and wonders, God is there. The problem with that, if there are no signs and wonders, Elijah thinks God is not there. And that's why he ran. There was no manifestation of God's presence when Jezebel threatened him. Wala akong Diyos eh. Hindi nagpakita ang Diyos eh. Walang fire. Walang signs and wonders. And that's why Elijah said, patay ako nito. Wala ang Diyos dito. I have to run. I heard some people, when in churches who is so engrossed with signs and wonders. Kailangan sa church may signs and wonders. Kailangan may patay na mabuhay sa church. Pag walang signs and wonders, wala ang Diyos dyan. Pag walang signs and wonders, pag walang miracles sa church na nangyayari, wala ang Diyos dyan. Have you heard those kind of remarks? Wrong! 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 And we see it here. After the fire, the sound of a low whisper. You know what whisper is? Gulong. Elijah heard yung gulong. Now, if the place is noisy, you can never hear a whisper. Right? If you're in West Edmonton Mall and, you know, and some people are whispering, you cannot hear them whisper. It's noisy. Right? It was total, after the fire, total silence. Like we have done earlier. Kung kanina, silence tayo ng 2 minutes, pinagsalita pa rin natin. Amen? With that silence, you can hear even a whisper. And that's what happened here. Elijah. Now, he didn't say what the voice, you know, what the whisper is. But I can only imagine, probably God said, Elijah, I'm here. And that's why in the next verse, Elijah heard it, he wrapped his face in his cloak, went out, and stood at the entrance of the cave. You see here? He wrapped his face in his cloak, Elijah's cloak, he wrapped his face, and went out of the cave. Alam din, andun ang Lord, nakikita niya yung glory of God. He went out, and stand before at the entrance of the cave, he's now standing before God. You know that Elijah now is at the presence of God. You remember the seraphim, the angels in Isaiah chapter 6? When they were like worshiping God, holy, 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 the seraphim has 6 wings. The two wings, they used to fly. The 2 wings, they cover their faces. The 2 wings, they cover their feet. Why do they cover their faces and their feet? First of all, because of the shining glory of God. Masisilaw ka sa glory of God. Pangalawa, they even feel that they're not worthy. No, they're not worthy. And that's what Elijah is experiencing right here. When he wrapped his face in a cloak. He couldn't stand the glory of God, and he's now humbling himself before God. Before this, when God asked, where are you, Elijah? What are you doing here, Elijah? And he mentioned that he was so disappointed. It was still that frustration. He is not ready to listen at that time. Hindi siya handa makinig sa Diyos. You know, sino parents dito? Parents, right? You know your children, pag may tantrum, right? Are they listening to you? Anak, kumain ka na, anak, maligo ka na, they're disappointed, they're frustrated, they're angry, they're not ready to listen. Kanina lang before we came here. Yung aking apo si Jayden, I don't know what happened, but he was like, paalis na kami, he was still lying on the coach. Anak, Jayden, come na. Let's go na. He was not ready to be, he's angry. Meron yata ang hindi binigay si Lola. See, when we're filled with anger and we're disappointed, there's so much noise in our minds, so much noise in our hearts, we're not in the position to listen to God. So dami ng problema natin. So dami ng worries natin. Yung mga pressures natin sa buhay. Hindi natin naririnig ang Diyos, di ba? When we're so in a hurry or in everything, urgent to, urgent that, gawin to, gawin that, we're so busy with life, we're not. We're not in the position to listen to God. Galit ka. You know, disappointed ka. It's like Elijah here. Probably you're disappointed with God. God. Tagal-tagal ko lang pinagpe-pray to Lord. I've been praying for this for a long time. And up to now, Lord, where are you? Where is the answer? Meron pa kayong prayer na gano'n? Ako meron. Mga single dito, baka matagal na nagpe-pray na, Lord, hindi mo naman ako, Lord. Hanggang ngayon, 2019 na, wala pa. When our hearts are filled with disappointments, anger,
So much noise.
We're not ready to listen to you. But know this. When God appeared to Elijah, there was silence. Silence. Meaning. There are times in our lives when we think God is not doing anything, God is working. There are times in our lives when we think God is silent. That's the time God wants to speak to us. There are times like Elijah, we feel like, Lord, just take my life. Take my life. I'm not better than my father's. We feel like we've failed. We feel like, Lord, I did not live up to your expectation. Lord, yung ginagawa ko, there's not, walang nangyayari. Lord, walang nangyayari, there's nothing happening in my life. There's no more sense, Lord. Just kunin mo na lang ako. But, remember Mary and Martha? When their brother Lazarus was sick, they sent a messenger to Jesus, Lord, please come. You know, your friend Lazarus is sick. What did Jesus do? May ginawa ba si Lord? Jesus waited till Lazarus died. But ganun si Lord. Kaya si Jesus, nung pumunta siya, went to Mary and Martha's place, sinalubong Mary Mary and Martha said to the Lord, Lord, if you have been here, di mangyayari to. If you have been here, my brother will still be alive. Ano sinasabi ni Mary and Martha? Lord, but wala kang ginawa, Lord. Why didn't you something? You could have come and healed my brother while he is still sick, and now he's dead, Lord. Late ka na, Lord, late ka na. It's too late. Sometimes when we see nothing is happening, we think God is not doing anything, right? Marami tayong problema, I'm sure. We have our problems at the workplace, problems with our families, everywhere. And when we see God, we're praying, Lord, kumilos ka, Lord, do something, God, do something, and we see God's not doing anything, and then something happened, Lord! Kung may ginawa na lang sana, Lord, kung pinrepet mo lang yun, Lord, sana maganda buhay. Maganda buhay ko, Lord. Hinayaan mo, Lord, hindi. What did you do, Lord? Elijah. Lord, binigyan ako ng death. Nasaan ka, Lord? I didn't see you. But even when things, we see nothing happening, we see here that God is doing something. God has a plan for Elijah. He is a great man of God. Remember, Elijah was one of those who came to meet Jesus in the New Testament. Elijah and Moses. He's a great man of God. And when Elijah humbled himself to God, that's the time he's ready to listen. When I say humble, means he surrendered to God. Before this, he didn't surrender to God. He ran away. He did this in his own way. He did it what he think is right. He was doing it in his own way. Kaya nga ang tanong ng Lord, what are you doing here, Elijah? Dapat dito ka. Dapat nandito ka. You should be here. Why are you there? What are you doing there? Maybe the Lord is talking to us today. Well, why are you there? You should be here. You should be here. See, Lord, Tem uma manter silêncio para pray por ele. Because it's a church. Tem problema. Ainda lá uma church. Lá com problema. Não. Sabe de Lord que ele vai dizer. Go, return. Go, return on your way to the wilderness of Damascus. When you arrive, you shall anoint Hazael to be king over Syria. Jehu, the son of Nimshi, you shall anoint to be king over Israel. Elisha, the son of Shaphat, you shall anoint him to be a prophet in your place. Ipapalit na sa'yo. Now this was not judgment. This was the plan of God. Kung naghintay lang si Elijah. If Elijah just waited on that time when he was like receiving the death threat, if he could just, Lord, I know you're here with me, I surrender my life to you, Lord, what's your plan, Lord? God could have said, may plan naman ako sa iyo. I have a plan for you. You know, I will not let you die that death. Kasi naunay takot. Huwag po natin hayaan yung takot. Mamuna sa atin. Amen? Yung worries, yung takot, huwag natin hayaan yan. God has a plan. Amen po ba? God has a plan. We may not be seeing it. You know, wala tayong nakikita manifestation, walang progress na nangyayari for our prayers. But believe this, God is listening. And God is with you. That's the promise of God. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Lagi ako nasa iyo. Madalas po hindi natin, we are not experiencing the presence of God. Una, because we're so troubled. Pangalawa, we're so busy. You know, wala nang time for silence from God. Think about it. Think about your life. Most of the time, what are we doing pag wala tayong ginagawa? Yung Facebook. Yun na lang. O kaya games, o kaya teleserye, o kaya pag wala tayong ginagawa, we want something to happen. Ayaw natin yung walang ginagawa, we don't want nothing is happening. We get bored in silence when we have nothing to do. We are bored. I tell you, you want to encounter God, you want to encounter the Lord, you want to hear from God, take a moment of silence. Be silent with God. Itong summer, you know, most of you have plans to go out. Yeah, that's good. I will not tell you not to do that. We have to. This is Canada. We have to do that. But my prayer is just you will put God first. Amen. When you go out, put God first. Meaning, spend a time. Probably you do camping and tenting. You know, wag na puro kain, puro kanta, puro. Okay lang yun. Ganda yun. Pero spend a moment of silence. Lift up your eyes. Wow. Lord. You know, spend a moment of silence before God. Mamangha tayo sa Diyos. Stand in awe of God. And that's the problem of many Christians today. There is no more awe of God in our lives. Wala nang awe of God. Why? Busy tayo masyado. We're always in a hurry. We're always like, do this, do that. Facebook, television, everything. It's like, all our time is occupied with many things. And we miss the glory of God. We miss to just stand in silence and meditate on how good God, how great God is. We miss those moments because we're so busy people. Amen po ba? Are you agreeing with me? Am I saying things that are wrong? I think we are. I find myself also like, I've been busy, I have no time. The last time, I spent 30 minutes of silence. Can you imagine, kanina 2 minutes? Last week, I spent 30 minutes of I set an alarm, 30 minutes, I'll just silence. No talking, no. I close the room, nothing, just silence. Meditating on God. It's so refreshing. God's word comes to mind. God's promises come to mind. Ang sarap. Ang sarap. Ang sarap. I pray that you will have those times. And then, that's the time you're ready to listen to God. Ah, thank you, Lord. Elijah received a death threat, disappointed, ran away. But I tell you, one person, he received death threat, but not only death threat, he was actually put to death. Isaiah 53 says, he is like a lamb led to slaughter. Para siyang tupa, napapatayin. You know whom I'm talking about. His name is Jesus. He's the Lamb of God. And Isaiah 53 says, he is like a lamb led to slaughter, but he is silent. He was silent. He was going to the slaughter. He was silent. In contrast to Elijah, death threat pa lang ito. Jesus was like, I'm doing the will of God. After this death, I will rise again. After my resurrection, I will ascend to my Father in heaven. There is assurances, there is hope, there's joy, there's peace, even when Jesus goes through the moment of death. Psalm 23 would say, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for the Lord is with me. The Lord is with me. Mga kapatid, just letting you know, even when God is silent, God is with you. Even when you think God is not doing anything, may ginagawa ang Diyos. May ginagawa ang Diyos. You're praying for your spouse, you're praying for your children, parang wala nangyayari. God is doing something. Believe it. God is doing something. The Bible says na patuloy, let's continue to trust in the Lord. Let's continue to serve the Lord. In proper time, we will reap a harvest. In proper time, God will show His miracles. We continue to believe. We continue to believe. And when those times happen, na parang failure tayo, parang nothing happened sa ating ministry, sa ating pamilya, everywhere, remember, God has a plan for your life. God has a purpose. Let me close in Habakkuk. In Habakkuk, we have the 3. Brother, I last verse. Sabi ni Habakkuk, you know, in the time of Habakkuk, ganun din, they were besieged by Syria. You know, so ang daming nawasak, everything is destroyed. But here, sabi ni Habakkuk, though the fig tree should not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, the produce of the olive fail, and the fields yield no food, the flock be cut from the fold, and there be no herds in the stalls. What is Habakkuk is saying? Nasabi ni Habakkuk, kahit walang bunga, kahit ganito ang pangyayari, kahit wala na kaming makain, sabi niya, I will rejoice in the Lord. I will take joy in the God of my salvation. God, the Lord, is my strength. He makes my feet like the deer's. He makes me tread on my high places. When you think God is doing nothing, God is doing something. Perhaps the Lord wants you to trust Him more. Matiwala tayo more. Pinapatibay yung ating faith. Pinapatibay yung ating pagtitiwala. The Lord wants you to grow in knowing Him, strengthen your faith in the Lord. The Lord wants you to be still and know God. Kumikilos po ang Diyos. God is working. We just have to be still. Don't panic, don't worry, don't fear. Just be still and know He is God. Amen? Palapakan po natin. God is good. God is good. God is good. If you are a believer of Jesus Christ, you have this peace, these assurances. But if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, I encourage you to come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Him. And you will have the peace, the hope, the joy that you cannot never find in this world. Only in Jesus you will find peace and hope and joy. Let's pray together. Worship team, let's ready for the last. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. You never fail to teach us, Lord. Never fail to encourage us. What happened with Elijah is a lesson for us, an encouraging lesson for us. Lord, forgive us when we think you have forgotten us. And we think you have failed us. Lord, you never did. Di po kayo nagkulang kailan mo. Di po kayo nagpabaya sa amin. Lord, in our waking up and in our lying down, you're always there. You're always there. Di man namin kayo nakikita, Lord, but you're always there providing for us, faithfully providing for us, watching over us, protecting us. You never fail to satisfy us. You never fail, Lord, to love us. Salamat. Thank you. We pray that like Elijah, we will humble ourselves, Lord, to you. We don't deserve anything, Lord. Pray that the more we will surrender our lives in you, we will trust in you and submit to your plans, Lord. Teach us to trust in you. When we don't understand things that are happening, Lord, teach us to trust in you, Lord. You're doing something. You are in control of all things. Thank you, Father. We give you praise and we give you all glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Tayo po tayo. Let's sing the song. Let's praise the Lord.